गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अभिजीत सर। वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर 3 एंड फॉर दिस वीडियो वी हैव द टॉपिक लिक्विड प्रेशर। सो प्रेशर एग्जर्टेड बाय लिक्विड, सी फर्स्ट वी कंसिडर दैट लिक्विड हैव देयर वेट, लिक्विड्स हैव देयर वेट। सो वाट इज वेट? वेट इज नथिंग बट द फोर्स अप्लाइड बाय द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द लिक्विड डाउनवर्ड। दैट मीन्स इफ समथिंग हैज़ वेट then it apply a force downward to the earth surface. Okay, now see this. Here we know that the pressure is equal to force by area, and that's why as this is because of weight of the liquid, the force is because of weight of the liquid, so it is equal to weight by area. Okay, now see, the area is what? The area of the circular bottom. Here we have a picture, na? So in this picture, this is the surface. This is the surface on which this liquid exists. Okay, now suppose that the air, the liquid present inside the container exert a pressure, suppose here at the surface. Okay, now here at the surface. Then the weight of the liquid causes the pressure. So that means the pressure exerted by the liquid can be measured at weight, that means the force by area. Here area is pi r square because this is a circular region. Okay, circular base. Now see here. Here I have mentioned that it is thrust because the force or weight is it is applied downward. Okay, in downward direction. Now see in this figure. Here we have this container, the same container, but now the bottom of the container is open, and here a rubber balloon is tied. Okay, a rubber balloon is tied. So if the liquid is filled inside the container, then the liquid exert a pressure on the air balloon, on the balloon, and causes a little inflation of this balloon or rubber balloon tied at the bottom. So that means the liquid inside it exerts the pressure on the surface of the balloon. Now see, so this is the liquid, this is the pressure exerted by the liquid due to its weight. Now one more thing is there for the liquid, that means the liquid have the tendency to see in this line it is mentioned that liquids do not have their fixed shape, so they have the tendency to take the shape to take the shape of the container where those are kept. So this is one of the reason why the liquid exert pressure. The weight is one of the reason, and this is also a reason. Okay, so there are two reasons. One reason is the weight of the liquid, and the second reason is it has the tendency to take the shape of the container where it is kept. Okay, now see, the liquid inside exert pressure on the wall of the bucket, because here we have considered in the two pictures. First I have to tell this, we have two pictures. This one is empty, okay, and this one is filled with liquid. This is a soft plastic bucket we are considering. That you may have experienced that whenever in a soft plastic bucket the liquid is filled, okay, so if we want to press it, okay, then it can be easily pressed if it is empty. But suppose that if some liquid or water is filled inside the bucket, and now we want to press it like this by our two hands, okay, then it can't be pressed. Why? Because inside the bucket there is some liquid, and this liquid exert a pressure on the walls of the bucket and causes not compressing and don't causes the compress. Okay, that means it cannot be compressed. Now see, here we have the next figure. In this figure we are also mentioning that the liquid exert pressure due to its weight. Now suppose that there are two containers. Okay, see, one of the container, the two holes are made here at the height h. Okay, so here two holes are there. So whenever liquid is filled, the liquid will flow out from these holes. Okay, now like this. So the liquid is thrown up to a distance from the container, and this gives a partial measurement of the pressure. That means we can say that the pressure is higher or the pressure is lesser. So here, from that much of height, the pressure is same, the pressure exerted by that much of liquid. Okay, let's see. Here at this height, the liquid above this height is this. Okay, and due to the weight of this liquid, the pressure exerted here, and it throws out the water, throws out the liquid up to here. But what we found, that the liquid is thrown out, a distance is same on both the side. So this gives, this tells us, that means this this informs us that liquid exert pressure in all direction, in liquid exert equal pressure in all direction. Okay, and also it confirms here that the liquid exert a pressure due to its weight. Now see this figure, it will be more clear. Here we have the holes at two different height, h1 and h2. Okay, so first of all, at this height h1, less liquid is present, so it means less liquid is present, so less pressure is exerted by due to less weight of liquid. So see, this is the hole, throw out the liquid up to that much of distance. Now it is less as compared to this, because here we have the hole at the height h2, so here more water, more liquid is present, the weight is greater, so pressure exerted is greater, so it throw out the liquid to a far distance as compared to this. Okay, so it is clear that liquid exert pressure in both all the direction. Now so this is mentioned here, that liquid exert pressure. One more example is here, that suppose that we have a inflated balloon filled with air, okay, na, and it is fixed by gum inside the bucket. Okay, that means it is fixed with gum, and now we fill the water in the can or jar. Then what happened? See, whenever we fill more and more water, then the pressure exerted by water on the inflated balloon is greater, and at some moment when the water rises up to very high level, that means weight of water become very high, then it causes the bursting of the balloon even. Okay, na? And one more thing is here, the liquid exert the pressure from all the direction on the balloon. Okay, so if more water is filled, the balloon is compressed more, and if the water is filled up to too much, that means the water is filled up to a greater height, okay, that may cause the bursting of the balloon. Now see the factors that those affect the liquid pressure. So first we have discussed that mass causes the weight, and this is the reason, this is one of the factors that affect the liquid pressure. Weight is one of the reason that affect the liquid pressure. See, it is mentioned that the height of the level of the liquid column, this ensures that the greater quantity of liquid with greater mass or greater weight, greater mass means greater weight, and thus the weight is greater, and the P, that is the pressure, W by A becomes see, at a height, we are saying that it is a height, it is the same height, so for the same height the weight of the water above the height is same. So here at the same height the liquid exerts same pressure in all the direction. So this pressure increases when the W increases. Okay, that means if we go below the level, then the water above the level is high, is much greater, have more weight, so it causes extra or more pressure. Okay, now the density is one more factor. Density is equal to mass by volume. So if it is mass, then we know that the pressure is directly, pressure depends on mass. So that means we can say that for the same volume of the density, if the density increases, for the same value, volume, if the density is increases, then there is only and only the mass increase. Only and only reason, that the mass is increasing. And if the mass is increasing, see, suppose that the density is increasing, then volume is constant. Then this increase in density is caused because of this increase in mass. So if the mass is increases, the weight is increases, and if the weight is increases, this increases the exerted pressure P. Okay. Now, how to measure the liquid pressure? We have an instrument to measure the liquid pressure. It is called manometer, and it is the instrument. It is an instrument used to measure the liquid pressure. Okay, see how it is working. First, see the construction. It is a U-shaped tube fixed on a broad, fixed on a board with a long scale. It is filled with water or mercury. The tube opened by one end and enclosed by other end with a rubber tube attached with a funnel. So see this, the mouth of the funnel is covered with a thin membrane. So first see the figure, you can easily understand. Let me zoom the figure. See this, this is the figure, U-shaped figure. You can see this is a U-shaped figure. Okay, and it has two arms. You see figure, two arms. So one of the arm, that means the tube is fixed on a board. One of the arm, the scale, this scale, and the in one of the arm, whatever the level of the mercury or water present inside measures the pressure of the liquid. See how it is happening. See, this funnel is closed by a membrane, and suppose we are to be measure the pressure of a liquid, and we insert this funnel in the liquid. Suppose this is a bucket, and inside there is some liquid. So we insert this funnel inside the liquid. Then what happened? This liquid exert a pressure on the thin membrane. Okay, here the thin membrane is present. Here at the mouth of the funnel, the thin membrane is present, and this is the liquid. So this liquid exerts a pressure on this thin membrane, and due to this, the air inside this rubber tube presses this mercury or this water level. And if it is pressed like this, okay, na? See, you can easily understand. That means here the air compressing the mercury level here like this on this arm of the U-shaped tube. So this causes pressure in this arm and causes the rising up level in this arm, and this causes higher in the pressure. Okay, so in this way we can take the reading here from the scale, and in this way you can measure the liquid pressure. All the things are mentioned here. You can easily read those things and you can understand the working. It is mentioned step by step. Okay, so this is it. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.